Alright everyone, I've got to weigh in on a film, and I normally don't do that. This is a forthcoming movie, I think it's coming out next year actually. And this is actually real. When you watch this trailer, link in the description archived of course, but you can go to the trailer for it. When you do that, keep in mind this is not actually satire at all. It's meant to be comedic in nature, but it's just completely off the chain. It's called The American Society of Magical Negroes. At first, I figured it was a Stephen King documentary. Have you ever read his books? Most of them have at least one side foil that has to do with a black person with some sort of psychic or magical powers. Ever The Stand comes to mind, etc. Anyway, but no, it's actually the basic plot of the movie seems to be that there's this world in which white people predominate. They run the show. And there's this society of black people who have magical powers, and the goal is that they can take a reading of like how stressed or angry or whatever a white person is, and their job is to intervene and make them feel better. So basically like being like a Sambo stereotype, in all honesty. I have a feeling that this movie is either going to soar or completely bomb at the box office, by the way. People might watch it just because it's so wackadoodle and end up actually making it profitable. More likely it just flops, though. There's this one individual, he's inducted into the Society of Magical Negroes, but he falls in love with a white woman. And in this world, you're not allowed to do that. And so I guess the idea is that if he does anything with her, if he breaks his oath to the Magical Society, that he'll have his mind erased and be booted out, and he won't even remember her and stuff like that. And it's just, again, it's meant to be a comedy movie. But it's almost not entirely clear whether this is wokeness absolute and defined, like textbook total wokeness, 100% diversity and inclusion level, or whether it's actually sort of a reverse foil whereby it goes so far over the line of wokeness that it becomes self-satire more than anything else. I'm almost leaning towards the latter. It's almost self-deprecating at some degree because You've made the ultimate DEI movie. Like, I can't think of anything that comes close, honestly. At least it's got a plot line that's kind of unique. they were the first ones to think it up, and they're hoping to get to the bank. And if it flops, well, it's a diverse movie. It checks all the boxes now, doesn't it? You've got a lot of black characters, you know, some of which are, they've got magical powers and shit. You know, they're like, well, I think one line in there is, the dude says, we try to keep white people calm, so they'll leave us alone, basically. And I guess, you know, they're able to live a normal life and use all of these magical powers, and it's not entirely clear why they wouldn't use them to, you know, break from their bondage or something like that. It's definitely not a Martin Luther King movie. It's peak wokeness. It's almost like, has wokeness gone so far that it's becoming so much of a self-joke that it's becoming anti-woke? That might be what we're seeing with this. Because, I mean, how are you going to top this? I'm not a film writer or anything like that, so off the top of my head, I can't think of a plot that would be more woke. To the point where it is kind of funny. I don't know. Maybe I have to watch it. Pirate it off the internet. I'm just joking, YouTube, by the way. This is asinine. Again, I've seen some, you know, there's plenty of movies that are pointed in a racial sense, or, you know, you think of like the Ghostbusters so-called reboot, and basically it was just ripping off a beloved franchise. I never was a huge fan, but a lot of people I know are. And then just swapping out the male characters for females, and then adding vague lesbian references and woman's lib sort of references. And that bombed. I wonder why. And now you've got this. This manages to go further. This is like, imagine, take the top three other woke movies that have been made, roll them all up together, and it would be probably approach the level of woke that we're seeing here. And this is what film has, by the way, devolved into, although, again, I will point out, the plot at least has some unique facets to it, so it actually does have at least a couple of redeeming qualities, which is kind of odd for such an obviously woke movie. But looking at it, it's almost confusing. I don't even know how to fully interpret it because it becomes a self-joke. And it looks like it'll actually achieve its comedic goals, but not for the stated and intended reason. It's, I mean, can you imagine when they were dreaming up the idea for this movie? How funny it actually would have been to watch them scrambling for ideas and let's see. We gotta make a movie. We need that DEI money. It'll give black people magical powers, but somehow they're still effectively enslaved. This is going to be empowering, and we'll make it funny. But really, it's more like a minstrel show than anything else. Or not a minstrel show, but it's like a Sambo sort of thing. Sambo and Mammy. Stereotypes. Stuff like that. But made humorous. I've noticed that the left is doing this a lot lately. Like, they go so far that they come around full circle, and this is the culminated result. So yeah, I mean, if you enjoy very bizarre films that, in the end, may or may not be funny, it depends on how well written the jokes and stuff are. The basic plot foil at least has a humorous quality to it. Then take a look. The American Society of Magical Negroes. Sadly, again, this is not a documentary, an autobiographical view of Stephen King's literature and how he manages to jury-rig psychic powers into every novel that he makes without further explanation. That's about all. Peace out.